Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's lecture, which is on maxillofacial prosthetics. End of this lecture, you are expected to know the classification of maxillofacial defects and prostheses. You should be able to describe the obturator prostheses and splints, and you should be able to summarize the materials used in fabrication of maxillofacial prostheses. To introduce, maxillofacial abnormalities are described as congenital structural deformities, malformations, or other abnormalities of the maxilla, face, or facial bones. In most cases, abnormal development of facial organs and oral cavity can affect the facial functions, shape of the face, and personal appearance, which can considerably cause psychological and emotional problems, such as lack of self-confidence, low self-esteem, and poor quality of life. As the patient's quality of life is significantly altered, social integration becomes difficult and the expectation to return to normal life collapses. So what is maxillofacial prosthodontics? Maxillofacial prosthodontics or maxillofacial prosthetics is a particular branch of dentistry that treats congenital and acquired defects of the head and neck regions. It involves rehabilitation, managing, replacement and restoration of lost or missing structures and functions of the maxillofacial defects or disabilities. The objectives of maxillofacial prosthetics include the restoration of aesthetics or cosmetic appearance and conserving maxillofacial functions as well as psychological therapy. Maxillofacial prosthetics collaboratively integrates multiple disciplines including prosthetic dentistry, head and neck oncology, plastic surgery, and other related disciplines. In order to achieve success in the rehabilitation of a patient, it is necessary to integrate different health professionals. The team approach usually involves a surgeon, radiotherapist, speech therapist, psychiatrist, and dentist for prosthetic rehabilitation. Maxillofacial prosthetics is defined as the art and science of anatomic, functional or cosmetic reconstruction by means of non-living substitutes of those regions in the maxilla, mandible and face that are missing or defective because of surgical intervention, trauma, pathology or developmental or congenital malformations. Or maxillofacial prosthetics is the branch of prosthodontics concerned with the restoration and replacement of stomatognathic and craniofacial structures with prostheses that may or may not be removed on a regular basis. Maxillofacial prosthesis is indicated after surgical intervention, after trauma, or in presence of congenital defects or acquired defects. Benefits of maxillofacial prosthetics: restoring organ structure and functions. It has its cosmetic advantages, regaining self-confidence, and improvement of patient's quality of life. Coming to types of maxillofacial deformities, maxillofacial deformities can be classified as congenital, acquired, and developmental. Under congenital, we have the cleft palate, cleft lip, facial cleft, and missing ear. Acquired defects may be due to accidents or surgery and pathology. Developmental defects include prognathism and retrognathism. Types of maxillofacial prostheses. To classify maxillofacial prostheses based on the prosthetic positioning, there are two main types. They are the intraoral prostheses and the extraoral prostheses. Now, if you have a look at this chart, this is classification of maxillofacial prostheses based on the mode of retention and from there the area of coverage or the area that is being restored. So you have tissue retained maxillofacial prostheses, you have implant retained maxillofacial prostheses, you have tooth retained maxillofacial prostheses, and you have implant and tissue retained maxillofacial prostheses. Coming to extraoral prostheses, an extraoral prosthesis acts like a cosmetic bandage that camouflages surgical defects. With regard to aesthetic concerns, the most important feature of this prosthesis is the natural appearance in terms of size, shape, and color. that helps enhancing the patient's confidence. Material used is mostly silicone with high degree of flexibility and cosmetic advantages, which plays a major role in patient satisfaction. The types of extraoral prostheses are your orbital or ocular prostheses, auricular prostheses, and nasal prostheses. Now, if you have a look at this picture, on top you have auricular prostheses, which is implant supported prostheses, and then on the bottom you can see picture of a nasal prosthesis. Now, if you have a look at this slide, you can see pictures of patients who have been rehabilitated with nasal prosthesis and an orbital prosthesis. The nasal prosthesis here has been retained with the help of the patient's glasses or eyewear, and here the orbital prosthesis has been retained with the help of implants. Coming to intraoral prostheses, the main purpose of intraoral prosthetics is to restore function and appearance in patients with oral cavity defects. The material of the prosthesis is mainly made from acrylic due to its satisfactory flexibility and durability. The process involves several complex steps, starting from dental impression, surgical and prosthetic procedures. The types of intraoral prosthesis include obturators, speech aids, and infant feeding plates. So what are obturators? A maxillofacial prosthesis used to close a congenital or acquired tissue opening, primarily of the hard palate or the alveolar soft tissue structures. Prosthetic restoration of a defect often includes use of surgical obturator, interim obturator, and a definitive obturator. Types of obturators can be classified based on the phase of treatment, based on the material used, and based on the area of restoration. Based on the phase of treatment, obturators can be classified as surgical obturators, interim obturators, and definitive obturators. Surgical obturators are given during the surgical phase, that is immediately after the surgical procedure. Interim obturator is given during the healing phase, and the definitive obturator is given during the healed phase, which means there are no more tissue changes that are expected to happen. Coming to surgical obturators, a temporary maxillofacial prosthesis inserted during or immediately following surgical or traumatic loss of a portion or all of one or both maxillary bones and the alveolar structures. Immediate surgical obturator is an appliance which is constructed from the preoperative impression cast and inserted at the time of resection of the maxillae in the operating room. Now, if you have a look at the picture on the left, it shows squamous cell carcinoma of the right maxilla invading the bone. The picture on the right shows a surgical obturator which is wired in place after removal of the tumor. Advantages of the surgical obturator: this prosthesis provides a matrix on which the surgical packing can be placed. The prosthesis reduces the oral contamination of the wound, thus reducing the incidence of local infection. It enables the patient to speak more effectively post-operatively by reproducing the normal palatal contours. The prosthesis permits deglutition, thus the nasogastric tube may be removed at an earlier date. And it helps in reducing the period of hospitalization. Coming to interim obturators, it is a maxillofacial prosthesis which is made following completion of initial healing, following surgical resection of a portion or all of one or both maxillae. Frequently, many or all teeth in the defect area are replaced by this prosthesis. This prosthesis replaces the surgical obturator, which is usually inserted at or immediately following the resection. Generally, an interim obturator is made to facilitate closure of the resultant defect after initial healing has been completed. An alternative is to place this processes 7 to 10 days post-surgical. After initial healing and removal of the pack, the immediate obturator is usually discarded and replaced by transitional or temporary prostheses having a definite bulbous extension and occasionally artificial anterior teeth. If you have a look at the picture on the left, it shows a patient with a soft palate defect in the upper palate due to surgery to remove a mucoepidermoid cancer. On the right is a interim prosthesis for the soft palate defect. Coming to definitive prosthesis, it is a maxillofacial prosthesis that replaces part or all of the maxilla and associated teeth lost due to surgery or trauma. An important point to be made here is that a definitive obturator is made when it is deemed that further tissue changes or recurrence of tumor are unlikely and a more permanent prosthetic rehabilitation can be achieved, and this is intended for long-term use. 3 to 4 months after surgery, consideration may be given to the construction of a definitive obturator prosthesis. The timings will vary depending on the size of the defect, the prognosis of healing, prognosis of tumor control, the effectiveness of the present obturator, and the presence or absence of teeth. Now, this is the picture on the left shows you a large soft palate defect after surgery, and the picture on the right shows the picture of an obturator prosthesis for the same defect. Based on the material used, obturators can be classified as metal obturators, resin obturators, and silicone obturators. Based on the area of restoration, obturators are classified as palatal obturator and metal obturator. Ideal requirements of materials used in fabrication of maxillofacial prosthesis are that it should have lifelike feel and appearance, should be easy to color and characterize. It must be color stable when subjected to heat, cold, and sunlight, should be non-toxic, non-irritating, and biocompatible, and should be resilient enough and hygienic. Prosthetic materials used in fabrication of maxillofacial prosthesis include acrylic resins, latex, vinyl polymers and copolymers, polyurethane, silicone, and ventured structural polymers. Coming to retention of prosthesis, retention of prosthesis can be divided into anatomic retention and mechanical retention. Anatomic retention include retention from remaining natural teeth, the remaining alveolar ridge, and the residual hard palate. Mechanical retention include eyeglasses, medical grade adhesives, implants, attachments, and magnets. Talking about adhesives which play a major role in retention of a prosthesis, historically, facial prosthesis has been retained by various mechanical devices, and recently adhesives have been used. They are polymeric compounds which have been modified with solvents and tackifying fluids. Selection of adhesives is based on the biocompatibility, retentive properties, ease of applicability, removal on a daily basis, and nature of the material from which the prosthesis is fabricated. Adhesives to retain the maxillofacial prosthesis are available in the form of paste, liquid emulsions, spray-ons, double-sided tapes, and Velcro tape. This is the picture of the type of adhesives that are available to retain a maxillofacial prosthesis in place. Coming to tissue implants, Implants are processes surgically placed within the tissues to restore a defect in contour or in continuity. Implants that are made use of for retention of maxillofacial processes are facial silicone implants and mandibular implants. The facial silicone implants are used for restoring a defect in the contour of the face, whereas the mandibular implants are used to restore the mandibular continuity after tumor surgery. Coming to recent advances in the fabrication of a maxillofacial processes is the CAD-CAM, which is a computer-aided design and manufacturing system. The maxillofacial processes are usually fabricated on the basis of impressions made with dental impression material. The extent to which this process reproduces normal facial morphology depends on the clinical judgment of the individual fabricating the processes. The computer-aided design and manufacturing system for fabrication of maxillofacial processes provides a more consistently accurate reproduction of facial morphology. The technique: measurements are taken using a non-contact three-dimensional laser morphological measurement system and sent to a computer numerical controlled milling machine to generate a cast for the fabrication of the prosthesis. Facial contours are measured using a laser. This method minimizes patient discomfort and avoids soft tissue distortion often seen when using impression material. Now, this picture shows the design process and the methodology of the facial prosthesis manufacturing. The first picture shows data acquisition of the whole face and nose geometry. The second step will be virtual reconstruction of the nose and nose adjustment and positioning. Then comes manufacturing of the nose prototype through the rapid prototype technology. Then is mold fabrication, followed by manufacturing of the silicone processes and final fitting on the patient's face. To summarize, prosthetic rehabilitation of maxillofacial defects is most challenging. It requires teamwork from the surgical team and the prosthetic team for successful outcome of the processes. It is important to focus on restoring the function and aesthetics of an individual, thereby improving the psychological state of a patient after a trauma or surgery. Thank you.